Minutes.
Mr. Speaker, I thank the gentleman for yielding. I ask unanimous consent to revise and extend my remarks.
Without objection.
Mr. Speaker, I wrong support of children's health insurance program, but not this program and not this rule. Mr. Speaker, I've spent 26 years of my life as an OBGYN physician delivering over 5,000 babies. I have a number of reasons to be in opposition to this bill and this rule, but not the least of which is the way the Democratic majority pays for this, how they raise the $71 billion that they're required to and they're pay-go rules. And Mr. Speaker, that is this cigarette tax of 61 cents a pack. If you crunch those numbers to raise $71 billion to pay for this massive expansion so the Democrats can now cover an additional 4 million children under this program when there are only about 750,000 out there in the 100-200% federal poverty level of not being covered, it makes really no sense. And to pay for it, they would have to have 22 million additional men, women, and yes, maybe even some of those children I delivered take up the smoking habit. So what kind of sense does that make here? We're trying to provide health insurance for children, but we can only do it if we can encourage 22 million of their grandparents, parents, and indeed, yes, some of these very children I delivered to take up the smoking habit. It's like the Pied Piper, maybe being Ms. Pelosi, walking along, heading for a cliff, smoking cigarettes, and all these adults right behind them smoking cigarettes, and behind them these little children, and they're headed for that cliff, Mr. Speaker. This is a terrible bill. I am totally opposed to it. I'm not opposed to expanding the program to cover the uninsured that are eligible, or even increasing a bit, as the President has said he's willing to increase, maybe $10 billion of this program. But I'm opposed to this bill. It's wrong. Let's vote against the rule.
Gentleman's time has expired.
And I yield back.
Gentlewoman from New York.